Okay, I think I was told that there was a last semester was a talk on the similar topic, I think by Dominga Talida, I think. But I hope that my talk will be completely complementary to his talk, I think. So the topic of my talk is just a bulk quotient. So you consider the n-dimensional complex bulk. The set of all numbers that satisfies and this is a Hermitian symmetric domain of rank one. So it's a group of isometries automorphic group as isometries group of this ball. And just like connected component of identity, which is a orientation preserver, can just project a unitary group. Group of unitary matrices, which preserves Hermitian form. And so if gamma is a subgroup of which is discrete, then and co-compact. So this means the quotient space is a compact variety of complex. So if also this gamma is an arithmetic group, so I'm not going to define it. This place. Now this is also projective variety. Yes, P and one, right, of course. Yeah. And this is just a projective algebraic variety. But not necessarily smooth. So if gamma has no torsion element, then of course this will be like ux. Ux will be smooth project. So many varieties, a very interesting variety, arise in this way in this surface which I will be discussing in a moment. It's just the example of this guy. But before I start doing this particular surface, let me do a little prehistory, so let's consider a special case. I'll concentrate in the case n equal to 2, so this will be x will be the surface. So I take the field, which is a subatomic field, and take the integers here, and consider gamma as a special arithmetic group. When I write this PU of 2-1, I always think just this is a group of matrices and just mark the centrum. So just I kind of say just elements will be just matrices. So this will be all matrices, 3x3 matrices with entries in the rank of integers, which preserve Hermitian form, which is not kind of standard, but it just is almost standard. The R just will be just the generator of the real subfield, so it will be real now. Section of this. So real number. So this kind of the first example of this surface where this particular group, so I'll call this group by gamma M. This is really the long history, I think, just so they kind of the most beautiful example goes back to Hirzebruch. So we let M go to like 3 and 5, but let me start skip the case of 3, just m is equal to 5. In this case, you consider the subgroup which is a congruent subgroup. So you consider the kernel, all elements in the group which congruent to 1, multi-ideal 1 minus, and take the, so this group is just a complex reflection group. And the usual kind of notation for complex reflection group, this is a group of this notation, like dealing most of least, and the quotient by this group. So this is a normal subgroup, which is a reflection group. So this group comes really the symmetry group, which permutes this weights, because we have equal weights. This just will be symmetric group. Prime S5, and so this is just so. So my surface admits the. So if you take like X margin of this gamma of Y, will be just a. Oh, let me just first, and this will be the cover. And this cover is just the weighted projective plane. This is, sorry, this is your X, right? This is a ball mod gamma, right? And this is a prime, and this is ball mod gamma. So this is like cover, Galois cover, and this is just a the kind of algebra, automorphic form is freely generated by three elements and then of modular form. So this is just weighted projective space. And this is just Del Pezzo surface. Of degree 5. So what it means is we take 4 points in P2 and blow them up. And this is just the sits as a some linear section Grassmannian G2-5 subsurface of degree 5 and P5, and then on the surface, and in fact S5 is just the full group of automorphic group of the surface. What is it? What did I do? I think my X was just okay. It's better. Do this way. Okay. So S5 is just, this is just the Del Pezzo surface, so it's a, so call it Del Pezzo 5. And this is just automorphic group of this. You can also see this as a group of all Cremona transformations of P2 with four fundamental points. So this is just the permutation group of degree 5, and this is just the X on this surface. You can also consider the cover of this, so the, in the work of Herzebruch, he constructed certain abelian cover branch along the planes which joins the six planes, and that's just the kind of abelian cover corresponds to the subgroup of this group, which is a also congruent subgroup but corresponding to. Same thing, but your G is congruent to 1 mod the square of this ideal. And this is a abelian cover. And this group has no torsion, so just this is just really just smooth algebraic variety, which is a quotient of the ball by the torsion-free arithmetical subgroup. And this is a abelian, maximal abelian. It's an abelian cover of this. So the next case, which is a is less known, and I think it was never published by Isao Naruki. Even more interesting. So in this case, you now take the m is equal to 7, And so then again you get here, you define the same way as a group gamma 7, which is a group of all elements which are congruent to one mod this ideal. And in this case, this is just a K3 surface. So this is Naruki K3 surface. So on this surface acts the group which is a Klein group of 168. So this is a simple group of 168. And your quotient by this will be just a so some surface Y, but so it's not a weighted projective space. And so then again this surface admits the cover by this group, which is also defined like that, and this is abelian cover of this K3 surface, which is a ramified along 28 curves. So who are these curves? So just in the case of Kirzebruch, this is a cover ramified along really the lines of the Delpeter surface. There are 10 lines. When you block these 4 points, this Delpeter surface has 10 lines, and just this is just this abelian cover is ramified. This is like Kirzebruch abelian cover branch along this 10 lines. So in this case, there will be 28 curves on this K3 surface. So the surface has a admits 3 fibers. It is a singular surface, so this Picard number is equal to 20. So it's defined over Q, and this admits the 3 covers, like we call it, just notation, just like will be okay. Seven septagons, so that. Like in usual notation, just this is corresponds to this, and this one singular fiber like that. Yeah, so it's related to this. Yes, this is just this what I'm going to say. And so when do we see this? It also has 7 sections, so more than a little group for this elliptic surface. This is elliptic K3 surface. More than a group is just Z mod 7. So it has 7 disjoint sections. So just then you count the number of components here. 7 in each fiber gives you 21. 7 sections, which are disjoint sections, give you 28. And this is 28 curves which lie on the surface. And this cover corresponding to this congruent subgroup is a abelian cover ramified along this 28 curves. And on this curve, the group of Klein group L27 acts them in the same way as it acts on the 28 bitangents of a plane quartic. So it's the same kind of action on the set. And so that's only you get this cover, which is on which also L27 acts. Okay, just as you lift to this abelian cover. Again, so this is a so why these two surfaces are interesting, so that both of these surfaces are moduli spaces. So it's very often when just because, of course, from general theory of Hashimura variety, it should be, but it's very implicit. So of course, just every such bulk quotient divided by arithmetical group is a Hashimura variety. So just you can always give its moduli theoretical interpretation, but it's very hidden. So you have to like embed it into the Ziegel space and then just kind of interpret it as a certain abelian variety of special property of a tensor. It's just from the point of classical algebraic geometry, it's kind of nothing. You really see any geometry, but for in the case m is equal to 5, it was proven by Ishida, I think, that just this is a moduli space of this was proved by Konda. So in the case m equal, sorry, so Konda showed that this is a Delpeter surface of degree 5, so it's a moduli space of all K3 surfaces which admits the non-symplectic automorphs of order 5. So this will be two-dimensional moduli space, and this two-dimensional moduli space is isomorphic to the Delpeter surface. So for m is equal to 7, it's also proven by Konda very recently. So this surface, this K3 surface, Naruki K3 surface, is a moduli space K3 surfaces admitting a non-symplectic. Also, both of the surfaces are related, as Klaus noticed, and to marginal surfaces. So for example, in this construction, and this is proven by Naruki in his preprint. So this surface is a cover. So this is K3. Remember, this is K3, but it's covered by elliptic marginal surface. So this is just a universal family of elliptic curve together with a subgroup of cyclic group of order 7 and the group of sections. And so this is an elliptic marginal surface. And this cover of degree 7 is an elementary abelian group of rank 5 over F7. So this is group 5 copies of Zeidman 7. So then this cover can be factored. Just you. There's a cover of this elliptic marginal surface of level 7 of degree 7. And this was again considered earlier by, say, Klaus and other people. So what it is, just an elliptic marginal surface of degree 7 comes with 7 square sections. So it's of all elliptic curves in this marginal space, universal family of all elliptic curves with full level 7. So it has a 7 square, 49 sections. And so just if you add them up as a divisor on this surface, then it will be proven by Hulick and other people that it will be able to divide it by 7 that exists in the Picard group and take the cyclic cover of degree 7. And this is a kind of admits this kind of surface. And then this will be the cover of degree 7 square. And this is cover of degree 7 square. So just saw this kind of cover, abelian cover of this K3 surface of degrees 7 power 5 is decomposed in the kind of as a composition of this 3 morphisms. This is it. And the difference between the case m equal to 5 and m equal to 7 is essential. So remember, we have this Hirzebruch abelian cover, it was maximal abelian. So this was just a maximal torsion free subgroup which can contain in your group. In this case, it's not. So just so if you take the same kind of group, so this is a torsion free. But the maximal torsion free subgroup gives you quotient, which is this cover of the elliptic, marginal elliptic surface. So this is, as you, I hope, convinced you that this is really, there's a very explicit, and again, so this is a kind of general philosophical thing. When you see something which is has no moduli, and this is a singular K3 surface, it's always very, very hard to write it by equations. So just we know only a few kind of examples. So in K3 surfaces, we can really work pretty well, I think. But so the whole point of this was of my second half of this talk about the surface, but nobody knows how to construct them by any geometric means, whatever it means by geometric means. So this surface can be constructed very explicitly by equation. The equation is very beautiful. So just the surface admits a double cover, this Naruki surface. It just branch along very special, very beautiful set. So it branch along the sextic curve, which has the following property: take the triangle lines. And we'll see this triangle just in a moment when we do the Cartwright-Steger surface. And you take the sextic curve, which is a very peculiar one, so just it has a cusps. At each vertex of this triangle. And this kind of direction will be just corresponding cardinate axis. And they also have a D4 singularity, so ordinary triple point. So this is just has 3 branches. Each branch is just a kind of tension to this line here. And I can write it down by unique equation. So just to check. as soon as I give you this property uniquely determines the sexting because there are no moduli here. So the surface doesn't have any parameters. So just, and so just there is a unique curve of degree six with this property. If you take the double cower of projective plane ramified along this curve, you'll get this Naruki K3 surface here. So it's kind of too bad that just this is an old preprint of Naruki, which I had for many years, but it had never been published. I don't think only a few people really know about this beautiful surface of the cube. Okay, so this is just like to warm up. Let me go to the really main topic of my lecture. If you try to find something really similar, and of course the goal which I have not achieved and nobody yet have achieved, to give a kind of similar, very explicit construction of the surface. So what is this surface? Yeah. So of course, quotient of the surface by torsion free discrete subgroup has the property that by proportionality the surface of general type for which this equality holds, and conversely by Yau theorem, if you have a surface of general type for which equality holds, then this implies that your X is a bulk quotient by torsion free discrete subgroup. So in fact, all these abelian covers, the examples of that kind. So for example, the Hirzebruch surface corresponding to m equal to 5 is a surface that first was constructed explicitly by Hirzebruch exactly to show examples of the surfaces for which this Miao-Kayao equality holds. And then this is just, but it's highly non-regular surface. I think in case m equal to 5, the irregularity q of the surface is equal to 30. And I think for Naruki surface, this irregularity is like maybe 64 or something like that. So it's a very high irregularity surface. So if you ask for a surface with the minimum possible number, so which will be C2 is equal to 3, and ask that your irregularity is equal to 1, this of course also implies that PG is equal to 1, geometrical genus. There exist two such surfaces, which are kind of complex structure, differ by complex conjugation. This was proven by Cartwright, Donald Cartwright, and Tim Steger in the search of the fake plane. So if you ask additional q is equal to 0, this is what's called the fake plane. And remember, there exist 100 of them, also paired by the complex conjugation. But again, so none of them admit any explicit geometric construction. So I was thinking about this problem practically all my mathematical life, since the Mumford first constructed such surface. And so this is just the failure of my life. So just so I can, from time to time, especially after this period, when just after this classification, I just, of course, I came back to this. But still, just there is a kind of some property of some elliptic surfaces, which you have to kind of realize, which I don't know how to do it. So there are none on the surface that meets any explicit geometric construction, except using some transcendental methods of periodic uniformization, or just constructing explicitly the corresponding fundamental groups, which will be a group in gamma. So this is a surface, just which was called Cartwright Steger surface I want to talk about. Again, so this is just a report on the failure, but I think this is where really close. I think this sort of, so you start seeing the equation. I think this sort of, and probably help of computers, maybe it could be achieved. Okay, so let me just remind the property of this surface. So the group is just corresponds to similar group, and this group is just corresponds to m equal to 12 instead of like 5 and 7. So you take the group gamma 12 and consider as a group of, again, all 3 by 3 matrices whose entries are integers in the cycloatomic field, and they preserve the Hermitian form, which is similar to the previous case. Just you take this Hermitian form Again, I just which of course we have square root, so you take it positive square root of 3. So just so this is a particular case, so just you also consider the so the group which will be here is also congruent subgroup, but it's a little more complicated. So what you do, just you take the two reduction homomorphisms, this homomorphism, this group admits two homomorphisms to PU 3, 4, and this is unitary group, finite group, unitary group of in three variables over field of two elements, and just of course the unitary comes from your Frobenius. Okay, so just you can really also see that just automorphous group of Fermat cubic in characteristic 2. If you take characteristic 2, then just take automorphic group of this plane curve and characteristic 2. This will be a group of order 156. And there's another homomorphism of this group to 3, 9. Again, this is just like F4. So I kind of differ from Atlas notation. So in Atlas notation, it will be just a U3, 3 and U3, 2. And this time, this will be automorphous group of the plane quartic in characteristic 3. Fermat quartic. And this group is of order 6048. So this also has a homomorphism to like determinant. And so the group gamma in Cartwright surface defined as a kernel, intersection of kernels of the composition of Roma 1 determinant and the kernel of Roma 2. And this is the group. So this is the arithmetical group acting on the Hermitian plane, and the quotient is just a surface with this property. So the quotient is a Cartwright Steger surface. So the Q equal to 1 condition is just you compute the commutator of the group. And so so you find that just your H1 of your surface is equal to 2. So in particular, it has no torsion, and the irregularity of the surface there is equal to 1. So you also compute that your, and this is very easy, it just also has no torsion, and so this is equal to Z5. So free abelian group. So again, you start seeing the similarity between this group, which is a really more complicated group, and the groups which I considered before for m is equal to 5 and m equal to 7. So by the way, I didn't say that also this group gamma, like remember gamma 5, it was a complex reflection group. This is also generated by unitary reflection, and it's not in the like Deligne-Mumford, not in one of the standard group in Deligne-Mumford. Deligne most or least, but I think just but it's commensurable to one of these groups. But I don't know exactly. I think in Naruki doesn't write exactly, and I didn't find out exactly to which group is just commensurable. I think so. Just there are some groups with complex reflections of order 7. So I think this is just also reflection. So this group is also contains the. So if you. So this group is just contains. So now this is my group. It also contains the reflection group, so which is this group. So and then the quotient gamma gamma prime is just the symmetry group of this thing. S3. So this is kind of semi-Dirac product. Your group gamma, this for the Cartwright surface, just the semi-Dirac product of this complex reflection groups, which you can find in the, I think, in the Deligne-Moster list. And the quotient S3. So just one, now you start seeing, just if you take the quotient by of the ball, so this is my surface, not my surface, Cartwright figure surface. If you take this gamma, you go to the B to okay, sorry. So that's right. I guess you do. Oh, gamma 12, I think. Sorry. Right. Let me start again. So just you have this gamma. Yes, all subgroups. I think. Yeah. Gamma is subgroup of this gamma. Gamma 12, right? This was just like conquering some group. So this, okay, this surface, my gamma, yeah, map to the, by this reflection group. And this will be just P2. And then you also map it by S3, by gamma prime, S3. And this will be, again, which is, you see again similarity to the previous cases, will be the same weighted projective plane. And this is my surface. Yeah. So this is the power of degree 3000 times 288. So again, this is all Galois covers. Okay, so this, so it's a Galois cover of the projective plane. No, I think notation is just so gamma is a, so this is contained gamma in gamma prime. Okay, this is bigger. So gamma 12 contains reflection. Maybe this is what I said is wrong. So gamma 12, the whole group contains gamma prime. Okay, so this is a larger group. So you define it will be P2. And this is just also on this group. It's contained in the larger group, which is you divide by the symmetry of this weight. So this is. Okay, so this is not the gamma, but I think gamma 12. Yeah. Okay. Okay, so now this comes to the geometry of this thing. So what can we get from this cover? So there are special curves on the surface which comes from the mirrors of these reflection groups. So like on this, there are two types of mirrors. So just on P2, just you now get the same kind of triangle. Okay, everyone has this picture. So this is my picture on P2. And there are two types of reflection mirrors corresponding to reflection groups. One corresponds to the sides of these triangles, and one corresponds to diagonal. When we go to weighted projective space, the image of the three triangles will be just cuspidal curve. So this will be like in P1, 2, 3. And this is kind of discriminant for the cover of this corresponding test reaction. And this will be just this is just like we call the A types mirrors. They correspond to diagonals. And of course, the other mirrors correspond to coordinate axis, and this will be just another, it will be just line, just like coordinate line in this space. And this is just intersect. It's tangent at this point, so this point will be like, call it P2. So this point is just P1. This cusp, this point will be P3. And there will be a point P4. And there are two singular points, of course, you can see it, this weighted projective plane. And obviously it has two singular points, one point corresponding to the stabilizer for the three, and this is a two singular type, a double Russian point. And this field kind of doesn't lie on the mirrors. So this is a three singularity. And then just this point is just a one singularity. This comes from the isotropic group corresponding to this two. So this is sits on this mirror. On this mirror. It's A1 and this is A2 singularity. A2. So now we can get the curves on my surface by taking the preimages of this curve. So now we take the preimage of the curve dA and take preimage of the, this line and see what it will be. And then the so preimage of the, so let's call this projection pi, this total projection. And just to take the pi minus 1 of dA. And this is case, consists of a pure curve. And pi. So all these curves, like all curves EI and C1 and C2, are genus, geometrical genus, they're singular curves. Geometric genus 4. And this curve C3, C4, geometric genus 10. Okay. So there are also special points. Which are preimage of the point P2. And this curve has singularity at this point. So it will be three orbits corresponding to P1. And then just will be singularity of this curve. For example, so at this point, like if you take this kind of table and put here multiplicities of the corresponding points, so then the curve so this curve has special things. This will be just 1, 4, 1. And I think this will be just like 2, 3, 1, and 1. I have this table. Okay. Three, one, two. And 2, 1, 3. So this is just means this curve has at one of this point has a multiple point of multiplicity 4. And so when you can figure out what's arithmetical genus and everything else, and geometrical genus is equal to 4 of this curve. So what's, since irregularity is equal to 1, just then there is a Albanese map. So let's say A will be mapped from your surface to torus, which is Albanese. Okay. And this is an elliptic curve. In fact, this is an elliptic curve with complex multiplication by root of unity, by like. So this will be the automorphism of order 6. And then just this is just so this is just vibration. Albanese vibration. So the first one, in fact, also there is a If you take the normalizer of your group gamma, this will be for the 3. This all comes from computation of the Cartwright and Steger. And so this means the existence of the Morpheus group. For the 3, which kind of descends to the automorphic group of your Albanese curve, and this is, gives you this extra automorphic of this elliptic curve. And so this is just the automorphic group acting connect. So just so you can. So, yeah, okay. So this has been for a lot of time, I think, since we just first learned this. Learned about this surface, I think we just try to compute the genus of the surface. And just the only thing what you can get from the kind of trivial algebraic geometrical arguments is see that the genus of the Fabrician must be congruent to 1 mod 3. And of course, we assumed just this kind of like thinking that nature must be as simple as possible, the genus is equal to 4. In fact, there was an attempt, erroneous attempts, to prove that this is genus equal to 4. But it turns out it's wrong, and there's just more kind of computer computation shows that genus equal to 19. Okay, so this is the first, in fact, let me just, this is the first new result in the recent preprint of Cartwright and what people are thinking. And this is, I think, the result of the very recent result of Cartwright. And Cozier, this I don't know. Probably young man, Cozier, and Saikai-Yu. So they also they prove the following theorem, which I think was independently proven by claimed by other people like Catanese, Domingo Toledo, Storer, Kuhn, and this is just the following theorem. So first, so they didn't prove that genus is equal to 19, but the first question, so what will be the fixed point? The first assertion discussed the fixed points of this automorphism of order 3 on this surface. And so they proved that just this is just a 9 fixed points. And so this is your points has all 1 or 2 or 3. And of course they all lie on the 3 orbits of fixed points on your Albanese curve. So there will be 9 fixed points. And so over these points, O1, O2, O3, which for which this is EI's. So this is a point just this point 1, 3, 1, 1, cyclic singularity. And they're the same. And here just this is a cyclic singularity, which is a type 1, 3. 1, 2. So this is just a kind of, this is not difficult to prove. But also interesting question, what, so this is the first assertion. Second assertion, this is about single fibers Albanese. So again, since you know that your C2 is equal to 3, so just a general formal tells you just a kind of the Milnert number, so the singular fibers add up to 3. So just there are two possibilities. So one possibility will be just 3 fibers of that type. And so there will be 3 ordinary double points, which is simplifying Albanese. And another possibility, which is a A2 singularity, the stuck node. So singularity. And so they still can be decided. So just the only statement, just the 3 singularity of Albanese map, either the 3 ordinary double curve or ordinary singularity, they lie outside of this fixed point. And the second possibility, which hasn't been excluded in spite of many, many efforts, that could be just one A2 singularity, just this kind of only one singular fiber on the Serbanesi map. And it sits here at one of these points. And this will be just kind of tucked off. So this case hasn't been excluded. So this is just none by the team of this people, nor by Catanese, Talide, Stover, or Kuhn. I think this is case is still open. So what's of course interesting is just to divide the surface by this involution, by this automorphism of the three, and see what you can get. Because this surface, like irregular surface, is harder to get by equations than regular surface. So what we do just so this is just the main point of my lecture, so the possibility to construct this, geometrically construct the surface, come from if you attempt to construct its quotient, because as soon as you've done, you'll construct this surface as a unique triple cover, branch along, you know what. So now let's get the surface, say S, which will be X, not this value. So because you have an involution, so it has fixed points, so that of course the quotient is a, so I mean, of course we consider a minimal model of this thing. So this quotient has a singularity, so, but it's of course standard techniques in algebraic geometry to resolve them because we know the nature of the singularity. So what you do, the first blow up these points like over O1, O2, O3, and then you blow up three times over each point here. Again, this is of course, I don't think I have to explain this in this room. So just this will be curve minus one, minus one, minus one. And this curve will be just minus three, minus one, minus and this will be. And then you lift your involution to this blow up, so this will be like your X prime blow up. And now, of course, you lift this involution, but now involution doesn't have any isolated fixed points, so it's really fixed locus will be just the top of this curve. And the quotient will be on single surface. So kind of you lift this evolution, and this will be not singular. But when you just you take the quotient, then of course the usual kind of intersection theory tells you just the so you know that this curve just this will be just your curve will be just the minus three curve. This is downstairs. And then you see this curve downstairs will be just minus one curve. Image of minus one curve, and this will be minus three curves. This is on y, okay, for every such thing. And then, so what you'll see just it will be this curve minus one will be still minus one curve, so this will be three coming from here, three coming from here. You blow them down, and this is your minimum model. So now you blow down six curves and get my surfaces, and you prove. This is minimal. So what's its invariant to the surface? So again, this is a again very easy formula. So let's compute it. Just let me show that I still remember how to do it. Yeah. So this is just Hurwitz type formula. So when you blow up the your starter from the surface was equal to 3. When you blow up, then you blow up on 21 curves. You blow up 9 curves here, 9 curves here, and 3 curves here. So then it will be 24. 3 plus 21. Now this becomes Hurwitz formula. So now it will be 3 C2 of your quotient of your surface y minus twice, and you take the sum of error characteristic of your fixed loci. And so how many fixed loci you have? 1, 2, 3, and 12 from here, 6 from here, 6 from here, and 3, 15. And the error characteristic of P1 is 2. So then it will be 30, right? And so from this you'll get 18, right? Right? Yeah? 18? Okay, but now don't forget to blow down curves. And then you, so we blow down. So did I make a mistake? No, must be 22. No? No, 20, okay. 28, right? Okay. Okay, 28, right? Okay. Okay, so now you blow down six curves right here. Okay, so now you get your C2 of your S is 22. You also see that Q is equal to 0. So now it becomes regular surface. And your K square, or C1 square, is equal to 2. So this is now we come to surface of general type, K square is equal to 2, and PG is equal to 1. So there is a chapter in the Enrico's book on surfaces, which devoted to the surface, and also this paper of Barbieri about surfaces, because these surfaces they come up with a classification of by multi-canonical maps of the surface of general type. So like Barbieri theorem, and of course Enrico's stated this, if you take the two canonical linear system of S. You prove that it's general type, yeah, that's all that's because when just you have only isolated just you isolated fixed points, I think just so just so just you'll check if this is a general type, yeah, that's all. So and in fact, I'll give you the, so, in fact, yes, I think I missed it. Let me just give you the formula for canonical classes, then it will follow. Okay, let me just give you. In fact, you can only compute canonical classes, also part of this paper of Cartwright and Young. So your canonical class upstairs of the surface before you divide is numerically equivalent to this curve E3. And then just when you go down, then canonical class of S, this is my computation, but this just can be done. It's just linear equivalent to your image of this curve U3 plus image of the curve R2. Remember, so this E3 was this curve which has a at one of this on the point R2, it has singularity of order 4. When you blow up, just when you just take the quotient, this will be elliptic curve of self-intersection minus 3. And this will be so the both of them rational curves of self-intersection minus 3. And this is just k square is equal to 2. And from this follows that this is just the minimum model, in fact, in general time, of course. Because this will be an f and big, this device, or I think so. So this is a general time. So just you take the bicanonical linear system and just corresponding map from x. And this gives me x to E3. And again, the theorem of Barbieri tells this is, will be a birational map. So, what? No, no, for S, sorry. Yeah. And just of course, like K squared, remember, is equal to 2. So 2K squared is equal to 8. So the image is an optic surface. Of course, it's a highly singular, so it's not normal surface. So in fact, you can see what kind of the singularity of this curve. So the So it comes with a kind of double curve, this surface, and double curve of degree 14. So this will be just singular curve of this. It may also have some isolated double rational points, but it just it's irrelevant so far. So what's the important thing just to determine it's a double curve. How you get 14 is very easy, because you take the genus of a general member in this bicanonical linear system, and genus is equal to 7, which is computed by Hurwitz formula. And of course, if you take a general hyperplane section of your octet, you know the genus of a plane curve of degree 8, and the difference gives you degree of your double curve. Okay, and just your computers get your 14. Okay. So what's the? So there is, of course, there is special. So what do we know about this surface? So the Enriquez in his book studied the surfaces, and he showed that this is just your this. So classics knew how to compute canonical class of a surface sitting in P3 with like a ordinary kind of curves of singularities. And this is given by a joint linear system. So just a canonical class of this kind of the normalization. This will be surface now normalization of this non-normal surface in P3 in canonical classes corresponds to you take the linear system of just take the degree, and this will be just you take the surface of degree, so d minus 3. So this will be just the d minus 3, this is canonical class. So you see there must be the unique surface of degree d in this 5, so this will be d minus 4. So this will be 8 minus 4 is equal to 4. So it immediately follows from the adjunction formula that there exists a unique quartic which passes simply through this double curve, and this is defines your canonical linear system, because the PG is equal to 1. So there is a unique section of canonical class, and this comes from kind of some very special quartics which cuts out this double curve of degree 14 from this thing. Your bicanonical linear system will be given by curve of degree 7. In fact, Enriquez showed that this is a double curve is a complete intersection of this octet and a certain surface. So this will be curve, say, D, and D is a complete intersection, but taken with multiplicity form, not scheme theoretical, of my octet. So let's call this phi of X will be just my surface, like F. And this will be F intersects certain surface of degree 7. This is, comes with multiplicity form. So, of course, the challenge to find this sectic, which gives you intersection with F, just cuts out this double curve. So what do we know about this? First of all, remember I gave you the formula for canonical class. And so one special curve in canonical system, which is really, if you take the image of this curve, and then this curve in canonical curve. So the canonical curve consists of the union of two rational curves intersecting at 4 points. And then just, of course, if you take the image of this thing, this corresponds to very unique hyperplane. So just, this will be just, so this will be just union of two conics on the plane. So preimage, so which cuts with multiplicity 2. Preimage of hyperplane is a two-canonical system. If you want to cut out curve in canonical system, must be special hyperplane which touches your surface everywhere. And kind of reduced curve, preimage of the reduced curve will be a canonical linear system. And so the image of the solid slides in the plane, and this is a union of two conics. Intersecting 4 points. So this is what we know. So now comes the result of Catanese, who some years ago described bicanonical model of a surface with this property. So just, so we know, really almost know the equation. So just so. So Catanese, his really fundamental work on the Babbage conjecture some 20 years ago, found the determinantal representation of this octet. So he proved that the surface F can be given as a determinant of a matrix of size A, but 4 by 4. The matrix just consists of following. So first of all, let's take the cardinal solution. So this will be, so let's take the y1, y2, say y0 will be corresponds to sections of canonical linear system, and y0 square, which are denoted by w, this corresponds to sections basis of bicanonical linear system. So I have unknowns y1, y2, and y3. So this matrix will be just equal to y0, g. Let's say what is g. That's a. So this is your first entry. So this will be just the quartic polynomial. And this will be wq1, wq2. This is a symmetric matrix. And this will be matrix here. A. So this here. Matrix. M. So G is a cubic, homogeneous cubic. And Aij here, linear polynomial. And Q1, Q3, quadratic. Quadratic. And now also know the determinant of A. So you can prove it's equal to this union of the Stokonic. So it's known kind of the general theory of a determinantal representation of plane curves, but if you take the union of two conics, then there is a unique, up to certain natural equivalence, way to write it down as symmetric determinant. So this will be symmetric determinant of degree 4. So unfortunately, we still don't know parameter here. So two conics depend on one parameter, and this is just you can fix 4 points on the plane by projective transformation, then what's remained will be just your pencil of conics through these 4 points. So we don't know this parameter, because as soon as you have the parameter, and this must become a really special number, lambda, in this pencil, some special conic in the pencil, because as I keep telling you, this surface is unique. There's no moduli, no parameters. You can't really just one of the kind. So you can't allow any parameters in this construction. So there must be one value of this parameter which fixes this union of two conics, then it fixes this matrix. And then just what you have to kind of start trying this kind of different quadrics and get this kind of property of yourself. But unfortunately, just again, there are more information about this on the surface which I can tell you, but I think it doesn't much help to fix it. So this is the state of the art, I think. So I have to apologize that I didn't come here just to report about success, but rather report about failure, I think. Yeah. But I think this is as close as we can get to this kind of problem, I think. So we are working on this now with Fabrizio and Kuhn, just to fix this quadrics and just determine, because, and to see this kind of double curve really explicitly in terms of this group theory, just in terms of this curve CIs and just in EIs, and as soon as we get this curve, and just then we'll be able to get this matrix. But at least you almost see this kind of variation in this surface. As soon as you know this quotient, you will see this kind of right Ziegler surface. So just again, just I have 5 minutes just to say that it's all kind of very frustrating, why maybe there's some really special reason to see why it's really impossible to solve this problem and to find explicit geometric construction of this, for example, fake planes. So maybe just there we'll never find them. So let me just remind you what's the just for some of these people in this room, what's the challenge. So Again, you see many parallels. This is why I started my talk with giving examples of Naruki surface and Yoshida Hirzebruch surface. So at that time we achieved the goal, though this surface is also very special, they also kind of arithmetical quotient of the ball. They also have C1 squared is equal to 3C2. And nevertheless, we know there is a beautiful, purely geometrical construction of both of the surfaces. And we go to cyclotomic field of degree 12, and we finally come to the surface, which seems to be very, very hard to construct. And then, for example, for fake planes, the challenge to construct the fake planes are basically 100 fake planes, and none of them have been constructed. But the problem is we know some of these things. For example, the original fake plane of Mumford, which was first constructed by Mumford, comes from the following thing. That comes from elliptic surface. So we know that as soon as you construct elliptic surface with two multiple fires of multiplicity 2 and multiplicity 3, and has four fibers which are triangles, so it means the corresponding the Jacobian elliptic surface will be corresponds to Hesse pencil. This is a rational elliptic surface. And what we need on the surface, as soon as you construct, this is all the surface of this property can be easily described by a certain group of torsors. But what we need to construct Mumford fake plane is the surface has a smallest relative degree curve of degree 6. So that means the curve, which is this is a projection to P1, which is a multi-section of degree 6. And so suppose we can construct the surface which has this following property. So here it's degree 6, so it intersects these three fibers like that. But here just more peculiar, so that it's set here as a 5. And it's also every fiber must be intersected with 6. So suppose I can construct this section, then I am done. Then I claim as soon as you construct this elliptic surface with this particular property of the section, then the rest of it will be really very standard. We'll just take up some kind of cover of the surface, ramify it along certain curve length on the surface, then we construct the Mumford fake plane. And as soon as you know the construction of Mumford fake plane, there's other construction by Kuhn. There are many other fake planes which are constructed if you know the Mumford fake plane. But this is kind of example again, something which is really very, very hard to achieve. So we have no control. I just tell people who really worked with elliptic surfaces and know the difficulties of it. So the general thing, we can only construct a Jacobian vibration for this elliptic surface, and then choose a cohomology element, and then it fixes your two multiple fibers. But what we have no control, how you construct the six sections. Because we get maybe some six sections that it exists, but how does it intersect this particular components, we don't know. And there are I've worked on this thing all my life, and I don't know any kind of techniques which allows me to control all this special multi-section on this torsor. But this is just the challenge. In fact, I wrote a paper many years ago which I really construct the surface, but if you want to find it explicitly, you have to solve really huge system of linear equations with many unknowns, of very high degree polynomials, are completely hopeless for any computer to do it. Okay. So it must be some really geometric way to do it. So maybe it's really will never find it, but I think this is the same, you get this for Cartwright Steger surface, so the same kind of challenge, just very peculiar surface because it has no moduli, and that's why you have this difficulty to construct. Thank you.